This page was created to teach Black history. Unfortunately, the American educational system was designed to exclude our real historical account, so we are here to dismantle it. It's time to enlighten those of us who have been kept in the dark. I am a Black man who didn't know enough about my own history, so I began to dig deeper and do my own research. Black history is American history, so I want people of all races and cultures to join together to learn our history as one. Here, I will share all of my findings. Please like, follow, share, and subscribe to Teaching Black History.
The story of Jackie Moms Mabley. Loretta Mary Akin, known by her stage name, Jackie Moms Mabley, was born March 19, 1894, in North Carolina. She was one of 16 children born to James Akin and Mary Smith. Her father owned and operated several successful businesses, while her mother kept house and took in boarders. Her teenage years were tumultuous. At the age of 14, at the encouragement of her grandmother, Akin ran away to Cleveland, Ohio, joining a traveling style minstrel show starring Butterbeans and Susie, where she sang and entertained. By that time, Akin had given birth to two children that had resulted from being raped at age 11 by an elderly Black man and at age 13 by a white sheriff. Both children were given up for adoption. In 1909, a year after Akin left, her father was killed when a fire engine exploded while he was volunteering as a firefighter. Her mother took over the family's primary business, a general store. She was killed a few years later, run over by a truck while returning home from church on Christmas Day. Akin adopted the stage name Jackie Mabley, borrowing the name of an early boyfriend, Jack Mabley, who was also a performer. She remarked in a 1970 Ebony interview that he had taken so much from her, the least she could do was take his name from him. Mabley quickly became one of the most successful entertainers of the Chitlin circuit. Although, as a Black woman, her wages were meager, she made her New York City debut at Connie's Inn in Harlem. She came out as a lesbian in 1921 at the age of 27 and becoming one of the first openly gay comedians. During the 1920s and 1930s, she appeared in androgynous clothing and recorded several lesbian stand-up routines. During the 1950s, Mabley, influenced by the minstrel role she was filling for other comedians on the circuit, adopted the name Moms, and the appearance of a toothless, bed-ragged woman in a house dress and floppy hat. Mabley also credited the name to her grandmother, who had been a driving force in pursuit of her dreams. The non-threatening persona aided her in addressing topics too edgy for most comics of the time, including racism, sexuality, and having children after becoming a widow. A preference for handsome young men rather than old washed-up geezers became a signature bit. In the 1960s, Mabley became known to a wider white audience, playing Carnegie Hall in 1966 and 1962, and making a number of mainstream TV appearances, with multiple appearances on the Smothers Brother comedy show, Hour. Music became a regular part of her act, and a cover version of Abraham, Martin, and John hit number 35 on the Billboard Hot 100 on July 19, 1969, making Mabley, at 75, the oldest living person to have a U.S. top 40 hit. She played the Harlem Cultural Festival during this time. Mabley continued performing in the 1970s. In 1971, she appeared on the Pearl Bailey Show. Later that year, she opened for Ike and Tina Turner at the Greek Theater and sang a tribute to Louis Armstrong as part of her set. While filming the 1974 film Amazing Grace, her only film starring role, Mabley suffered a heart attack. She returned to work 3 weeks later after receiving a pacemaker. Mabley died from heart failure in White Plains, New York on May 23rd, 1975.